हरे कृष्णा। हम लोगों ने 10th क्लास का चैप्टर हमने फिनिश किया था। चैप्टर 1 केमिस्ट्री का, केमिकल रिएक्शन इन इक्वेशन, और जो लाइफ प्रोसेस है उसका हमने एक टॉपिक किया था न्यूट्रिशन। आज हम फिजिक्स पढ़ लेते हैं, थोड़ा सा चेंज हो जाएगा। तो फिजिक्स फिजिक्स में जो 12th चैप्टर है इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, वो हम करेंगे। इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज ए ब्रॉड टर्म, इट कवर्स दैट होल चैप्टर कवर करेंट, पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, रेजिस्टेंस, ओम्स लॉ, हीटिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ करेंट, सीरीज एंड पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन, पावर, दैट ऑल वी विल डू, चार्ज एंड टूडे आफ्टर द कंप्लीशन ऑफ द चैप्टर यू विल एबल टू गिव क्वेश्चंस ऑफ दीज 4 टॉपिक्स। सो फर्स्ट वी विल डू करेंट। टू टाइप्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, स्टैटिक इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड करेंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। दैट यू हैव डन इन जूनियर क्लासेस, चार्जेस आर एट रेस्ट। दिस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज ड्यू टू द चार्जेस आर नॉट इन मोशन। इन करेंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी चार्जेस मूव, एंड इन स्टैटिक इलेक्ट्रिसिटी चार्जेस आर एट रेस्ट। फॉर एग्जाम्पल दैट वेन यू कॉम योर हेयर्स, दैट कॉम देन कैन अट्रैक्ट द पेपर बेड्स, और वेन यू टेक ऑफ योर स्वेटर ड्यूरिंग विंटर्स यू कैन सी ए स्पैक ऑफ लाइट, ग्लो ऑफ लाइट, इट इज ड्यू टू स्टैटिक इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। वी विल डू करेंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। So here we will take first point, that is current. To understand the current, we have to learn what is charge. There are 2 types of charge particles. We select if we study atom, because here we will learn about the current in copper wire. That here. Copper wire means it is made up of copper atoms. So in atom, the charged particles are electrons and neutrons. Sorry, protons. Neutrons are neutral. We know electron have negative charge, proton has positive charge. And another types of charged particles are ions. These are cations, positive, anions, negative. For example, when NaCl is split in water, it makes Na positive, that is cation plus anion. That we will do in detail in 3rd chapter, metals and non-metals. So here we have our concern is to the current due to the flow of electrons, because we know in the atom protons and neutrons are bound in the nucleus and electrons revolves around. So here the current we are learning, that is due to the electrons. So what charged particles are here? Electrons. And if we have to calculate the total number of charge, so there is a formula Q is equal to Ne, and E is the charge on 1 electron. This is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. and n is the number of electrons and q is total charge. Now I and the unit of charge is coulomb. Current, it is depicted by I. This is rate of flow of charge. If these charged particles are flowing from any conductor, two types of materials are there. One from which allows electrons to pass are per conductor, like metals, best conductor is silver, then copper, and which don't allow electron. Insulator, for example, wood, rubber, plastic. So, rate of flow of charge is current, means these charged particles are flowing at what rate, means I is equal to Q upon T. Rate of flow of charge. Unit of I is ampere. And on the honor of André Pierre Ampere, this unit is given. And it is coulomb and it is second. So rate of flow of charge is current. Now question, generally in one more question, it is asked you what is 1 ampere. If 1 coulomb charge flows in 1 second, then current is 1 ampere. What is the unit of current? Ampere. There is small unit also, milliampere. 1 milliampere is equal to 10 is power minus 3 ampere and microampere. Small units. So if 1 coulomb charge flows in 1 second, then current is 1 ampere. And now if I ask how many electron will make 1 coulomb charge, it is an important question, it comes in exam. How many electron will make 1 coulomb charge? Like if I am tapping electron like this, if 1 electron is moving, I told you it is carrying 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Here I am asking how many electrons will move to make 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So Q is equal to N into E, total charge is 1, and number of electrons we have to find out, and charge 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So the value of N is equal to 1 upon 1.6 into 10 to the power 19. ये आप ऊपर लेके जाएंगे तो पॉजिटिव हो जाएगा 1.6. इस पॉइंट को यहां से हटाएंगे हम, तो ये हां 10, इसको और इजी कर लेंगे हम, 18 लिख देंगे हम और एक जीरो हम उधर ले लिए, 16, तो इट विल बी 6.25 into 10 to the power 18. इतने सारे इलेक्ट्रॉन्स जब मूव करेंगे तब एक कूलम चार्ज फॉर्म होगा. तो ये क्वेश्चन आता है एग्जाम में, प्लीज लर्न कीजिए. Now the instrument to me is a current is called ammeter. We depict it like this. It is always combined in series. ये हम और डिटेल में बाद में करेंगे, अभी जस्ट आप लर्न कीजिए कि इट इज कंबाइंड इन सीरीज बिकॉज इट गिव्स द मेजर ऑफ करेंट एंड इन सीरीज ऑलवेज करेंट इज सेम सो दैट वी विल लर्न आफ्टर ऑल एंड इंस्ट्रूमेंट विच शोज direction of current is galvanometer or whether current is flowing or not, that also it symbol is like this. Now to move the charged particles will not move like this only. Like copper wire, if you are having, it has copper atoms and it has electron in it, but electrons will not move like this only. As if water level is same all where, water will not flow. If the concentration of air is same everywhere, air will not flow. In the same way, to move the charged particles from one terminal to another terminal, there should be some difference in their concentration, in their power, in their pressure. So that we will do that difference is called potential difference. How for this, first we have to learn what is electric potential. If a unit positive charge is kept in infinity imagination and it is bring to our electric field which is shown like this, if we will bring this positive charge towards negative, less work to be done because opposite charge attract each other. But we have, if we are moving it towards positive end, then more work have to be done. So it is always at high potential and it is at low potential. So this is the difference in, if it is VAVV, the difference in the potential, this is called potential difference. One thing more, I forgot to tell you, that is the direction of electric current. Direction, device which provide potential difference is called cell. In cell, we know there are two terminals. This big line show positive terminal, this negative terminal. Now, if we join copper wire, now direction of electron is always negative to positive, and direction of conventional current is positive to negative. And here we are in our diagrams, in circuit we always show the direction of current, so it is always positive to negative. Why cell is important? This is a device cell. This is a device cell or battery. Battery ko simple kaise banayenge? This is battery. Device which provide potential difference are either cell or battery. equal to potential difference W upon Q. Its unit is volt. On the honor of Alessandro Volta, this is work, so it is measured in joule and it is coulomb. All the numerical equations we will do in MKS system. Meter, unit of length will be meter, unit of mass will be kilogram, and unit of time will be second. Meter, kilogram, second. So V is equal to W upon Q. Now another question, what is 1 volt? If 1 joule work has to be done, if it is 1 joule, if it is 1 coulomb, then it will be 1 volt. So if 1 joule work has to be done, is done to move 1 coulomb charge from one terminal to another, then ED between two terminals is 1 volt. Some numericals based on this. How much work is done in moving 2 coulomb charge? How much work has to be done? Work we have to find out to moving 2 coulomb charge if potential difference is 12 volt. Apply the formula. V is equal to W upon Q. 12 is equal to, that we have to find out 2. So, W is equal to 24 joule. Next question, how much energy is given? How much energy is given? Energy means work. To each coulomb. Each coulomb means Q is equal to 1. How much energy is given to each coulomb of charge passing through 6 volt battery? Again, V is equal to W upon Q. 6 is equal to W upon 1. So, W is equal to 6 joule. Next, 0.5 ampere current. So, I is equal to 0.5 ampere. 0.5 ampere current is drawn for 10 minutes. T is equal to 10 minutes according to MKS. 600 seconds. 0.5 ampere current is drawn for 10 minutes. Find the amount of charge. Q we have to find out. That flows. I is equal to Q upon T. 0.5 is equal to Q, we have to find out T is 600. So Q is equal to 0.5 into 600 is 300 coulomb. There are some symbols are given on page number 203. That symbols are the components of the circuit. That you have to learn very easy symbols. Like for cell, I told you this. For battery, it is like this. For closed switch, this. Open switch, this. Like that. resistance, variable resistance, that learn those symbols. What is circuit? Circuit is the path which shows the path of current. And different components can be shown in this, like to flow the current, conductor and battery, cell or battery, two things are necessary. But how to show them? If we will join bulb here, bulb will glow, that means current is flowing. We can attach a switch here, ammeter or more. These all are called the component of the circuit. So now current and potential difference are clear. Current is rate of flow of charge, and to flow the charge, potential difference is necessary, which is provided by cell or battery. Now Ohm's law. It shows the relation between current, potential difference and resistance. We can do a simple experiment. Number of cells, potential difference and current. If in a circuit we join one cell, for example it provides 1.5 volt potential difference and current 0.3. So the value of V upon I, we have to find out, it is 1.5 upon 0.3, that is 5. If two cells, 3 volt, if it is 0.6, then 3 upon 0.6 again 5. If 3 cells, for example, if it is 4.5, for example it is 9, 4.5 upon 0.95. In all cases, this value is constant. Value of V upon I is constant. To do this experiment, a simple circuit can be shown. Resistance wire, switch, ammeter, and number of cells are different. So number of cells we can show like this. One, two, how many cells we are joining. And this diagram is also given in your NCERT, page number 204. In a experiment it is shown. This diagram is important actually. It comes like this. Show the diagram of Ohm's law. So here we can see that V is proportional to I. If two factors are proportional or two quantities are proportional, that means if one is increasing, second will also increase. So here if V is increasing, then I is increasing. So V is proportional to I. Whenever we remove the symbol of proportional and put the symbol of is equal to, we have to put a constant over here. Here this constant is R. To find the value of R, it will be V upon I is equal to R. So the value of R is the resistance. Here that the constant value we are finding out, that comes when we are doing V upon I in each case, that constant value is actually the resistance. So from Ohm's law like this we can find out the resistance. And what is resistance? Resistance is the quality of a conductor, the property by which any conductor oppose the flow of electron is called resistance. Some have lower resistance, like copper, silver have lower resistance, and resistors that we will learn afterward, then the alloys, they have more resistance. So this is the means, if this is a copper wire, electrons are moving from this, the atoms of copper wire make hindrance in the flowing of electrons, And how much they are making hindrance? If they are making more hindrance, that means it has more resistance. If they are making less hindrance, that means it has less resistance. So this is resistance. Now this question is important actually. Now what is Ohm's law? The question is saying exam mein, what is Ohm's law? Define it and plot the graph between V and I. When two quantities are proportional to each other, graph between them is a straight line. And by getting the slope of this graph, we can know the resistance V upon it. This value will give you the, if here I is 10, here 20. So this value is GI, means difference in current, and this value will give you dV, difference in, if it is 5 or 10, it is difference in potential difference. So R is equal to dV upon dI. dV is 10 minus 5 and it is 20 minus 10. So it will be 5 upon 10 is equal to 0.5. And the unit of R is ohm. It is depicted like this. So this is 5 ohm. So in this way we can find out the resistance from Ohm's law. Now factors on which resistance depend. Length of conductor, R is proportional to length. If length is increased, means if wire is of this length and or this length, here resistance will be more, because here electrons will find lesser hindrance. Here they have to move that much length, they will find more hindrance. Area of cross section, R is inversely proportional to area of cross section. If area is bigger, electrons will move easily, that means lesser resistance. So area is more, resistance is lesser. Type of material. Resistors have more resistance than resistors, means alloys have more resistance than metals. And temperature. For conductor, if temperature is increased, resistance is also increased. Now two factors are there, these two. We will take them along. R is proportional to L and it is inversely proportional to A. So when we combine both of them, it will be R is proportional to L upon A. As I told you, when we remove the symbol of proportional, we have to put a constant over here. Here constant is rho L upon A. Rho is the resistivity. If we find out the formula of resistivity, it will be Re upon L. Resistivity is a nature of the material. If we find out the unit of resistivity, what is the unit of R? Ohm. Unit of area, meter square. Unit of length, meter. This is cut from this, then so ohm meter. Unit of resistivity is ohm meter, and it is a property of the material. It is a, like the boiling point is a property of the material. In the same way, resistivity is the property of the material. इट डज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन द लेंथ एरिया. जैसे कि अगर आप 1 लीटर वाटर लेंगे या फिर हम 2 लीटर लेंगे या 100 लीटर लेंगे, इट विल बॉयल ऑन 100 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. तो इसी तरह से रेजिस्टिविटी जो है, चाहे वायर इतना बड़ा है या इतना बड़ा है या फिर उसका एरिया ये है या कम है ज्यादा है, रेजिस्टिविटी विल ऑलवेज बी सेम. इट इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द मेटेरियल. क्वेश्चन आता है आपको, राइट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन रेजिस्टेंस एंड रेजिस्टिविटी. दैट फर्स्ट यू ट्राई टू राइट डाउन, देन आई विल टेल यू व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन रेजिस्टेंस एंड रेजिस्टिविटी. सो द क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दिस फॉर्मूला यू कैन हैव इन योर एग्जाम. सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस आर गिवन इन योर बुक बेस्ड ऑन दिस. On page number 208, examples are given in this example. Example 12.5 is based on this only. And 12.6. That we will do in next class. Till then, please do the new questions which are given on page number 200 and page number 202. And the questions which are related to this topic from this Lakhmir Singh Manjeet Kaur book that I told you the refresher and the from your NCERT also. So do these topics and revise previous topics, then we will do the assignment and I will take your test, and whatever doubts you have, please ask those doubts.